Hi viewers, I'm Dr. Lakshmi from Vishnu Educational Development and Innovation Center, Hyderabad. Today in this video, I'm presenting about art of writing research paper, research proposals, and thesis. Writing is a skill. Over the period, by doing again and again, skill could be acquired. Cutting a coconut is a skill. If you look at a coconut point, people will be cutting very quickly. In a minute, they will cut the coconut. Then they will offer you in a minute. But you and me, if you go and cut the coconut, it will be very difficult because we have not acquired that skill. But it is possible to a certain extent. If we practice over and over, again and again, cutting the coconut, then it will become easy for us over the period. Similarly, writing is a skill. Very first time, we may feel difficult, we may feel stressful in writing a paper. But if we practice writing again and again, it becomes easier. First time when we write, we commit a lot of mistakes. In the world, all the best letters are rewritten. Rewritten letters always appreciated. Similarly, when we write a paper, if we do n number of revisions on the same topic, then it would become the best paper. Finally, the message is writing and speaking is a skill. By practice, anyone can acquire the excellence. No one has to wait till becoming excellent. Excellence may not happen. We have to expand our shoulders. Slowly over the period, we will become excellent in the domain. Skill has to be acquired. Writing cannot be taught. Writing may be facilitated, may be supported. Cues can be provided by anyone in this world. But we have to practice it again and again. Skill has to be acquired. In doing research and conducting research, there are two major influencing factors plays a vital role in everyone's walk of life. One is cognitive factor, another one is emotive factor. Cognitive factors. Everyone should raise the conscious or raise their power of thinking. Power of thinking only can guide towards the successful research. The reasoning ability. There are four reasoning abilities majorly required for conducting a research. Logical abduction means determining the preconditions for the research. Problem statement, necessary hardwares and softwares, necessary mathematical formulas, necessary ideas. These all comes under logical abduction. Logical induction means determining the rule, methodology, algorithm, strategy. These all comes under logical abduction. Logical deduction means determining the conclusion after conducting several studies, after applying the algorithm, after applying the mathematical formula. What is the message or what is inference we would try to deduct after conducting the experimentation or the research that ultimately we can say conclusion? So arriving the conclusion, the process mathematically termed as logical deduction. Logical syllogism, closer related to mathematical reasoning. Relationship analysis, interpretations, this all comes under logical syllogism. Now, emotional factors. Everyone should have necessary mindset, research mindset. Looking at things in the perspective of research. Self-motivation. No mentor will be available throughout. Research has to come within self-motivation. Self-esteem, self-regulation, tenacity, firm and determination, time management. Every moment we should focus on the problem. Always human will have split personality or attention deficit. Whenever we speak with someone, whenever we are reading, internally a conflict will occur. Some portion of our being will focus on reading the material or listen to somebody's lecture. Half of the thoughts will be lingering with, wandering with some other items. Teacher may be teaching mathematics. Partially, we may be giving attention to that teacher. Then we may be wondering about what food our mom will be cooking in the evening, how we could spend time in the evening time, to whom we have to meet in the evening. Similarly, the attention will be splittered in two different dimensions. One, attending the lecture, the other face wandering with other unrelated elements. So we may have to focus together the full attention, the full tenacity, firm determination. We may have to regulate the thought towards the conduction of the research, focusing on the problem, the determination towards the aim and objective. Naturally, the totality of our being, the fullest, we will be focusing or channelizing our attention towards the problem statement or finding the solution. Then research becomes easy. For the successful conduction of research, definitely we should have a mentor. If you are lucky, your mentor will take care of you. Your mentor will stimulate your thinking capability. Your mentor will provide necessary materials. Your mentor will take care of your emotional regulation. Your mentor will take care of your end-to-end need of conducting the research, if you are lucky. If not, be like this. Try finding the right mentor. Get attached with them. You try to get associated with them. You have to rely on the mentor. You have to pull them. You have to request them. You have to please them. Then naturally, you may get your guidance from the mentor. Glenn's holistic thinking pyramid. Levels of thinking are layers of thinking. It's a code for conducting a research. Basic thinking. Normally, knowing about the facts, situation, places, people, who have good or bad or evil intentions. These all simple or basic thinking. Everyone, we have innate tendency to think certain extent towards anything in this world. Critical thinking. It should be concrete. Thinking about today's scenario or particular scenario, single scenario. Ability that allows a person to apply analytical reasoning and logic to events, attitudes, and practices of today gives consideration to the what factors. Reflective thinking, it's abstract in nature. It thinks about the past. Ability to connect the outcomes of today with the events, attitudes, and practices of yesterday. In simple terms, gives consideration to the why factors. If you mingle with the kids or small babies, they will look at the sky and they will ask you, what is this round yellow color means? What question easily can be answered? It's a moon. But the moment the question is moved to why moon looks yellow color, then we will be into embarrassing mode. Always answering to the why question is difficult. What is stack? Easily we can give definition. But why we have to use stack in particular circumstances? It becomes a little bit tough to answer. We may have to reflect. We may have to connect the dots. Always giving answer to the why question will become very difficult. Giving answer to the what question becomes very easy and simpler. Creative thinking, always focusing on the future. Ability to connect the events, attitudes, and practices of today with the outcomes of tomorrow gives consideration to the how factors. How my algorithm will be useful for the future endeavor. How my business would be successful in the future endeavor. Always, how will be little bit tougher. All the guide seeks for raising their scholar to the level of attaining answer to the how question. When anyone conduct a research, the research outcome is capable enough to answer to the question how you can publish your paper, you can submit your paper. This is the indication for submitting a paper after conducting the experimentation. Interpretive thinking. Ultimately, if anyone raises to the interpretive thinking level, PhD will be awarded. Every guide seeks for raising their scholar to the level of interpretive thinking. Integrating abstract and concrete ability to connect the practices of yesterday with the events and attitudes of today and outcomes of tomorrow. So interpretive thinking, you have to interpret with several algorithms. Finally, you have to comprehend and you have to announce interpretively with the past research, what you have done, and connecting with the future recommendations. Then it is termed as interpretive thinking. Are you surprised? Research has a geometric shape. Anyone, if want to conduct a research, take up a PhD problem, proposal, you may have to wonder, become aware of many things. See, this is the color shade shows mathematical knowledge, programming knowledge, application knowledge, hardware, software, so many. You may have to wander across so many facts, information, strategies, methods, etc. You should become aware of so many things to conduct your research, but you have to narrow down. Then you may have to familiar with certain band of knowledge, maybe certain mathematical principles, certain algorithmic principle. You may be familiar with one particular language in depth to conduct the experiment, something familiarity. Then once if you become familiar, you may have to go and dive deeper and deeper. Deeper learning should happen. Then finally, synthesize, analyze, and integrate the information sources and prior knowledge. Awareness can become wider, but the outlet or outcome of the research should be narrowed down. At the end of conducting a PhD research study or any proposal, we may give the announcement to this globe in one or two points. That would be the outcome of conducting a research or experimentation. What is the correct workflow when writing an article? Title, abstract, keywords. First you have to write. Subsequently, figure, tables, methods. Figure, tables, methods, results, discussion. Finally, conclusion, introduction. Second, figures are tables, methods are results are discussions, conclusion or introduction, title, abstract or keywords. Figures, tables, conclusion, introduction, methods, results, discussion, title, abstract, keywords. The fourth one, try introspecting yourself. Here I'm mentioning when writing an article, not reading an article. Reading an article has systematic flow, title, abstract, keywords, introduction. Similarly, we will move on. But here I'm mentioning when writing an article, the order is absolutely different from reading an article. Think a while. That's right. The correct option is option two. The sequence of writing article is not the same as reading it. First, you start with figures and tables, then the methods, results, and discussion. followed by your conclusion and introduction, followed by your titles, abstract. The last elements you write are the title, abstract, and keywords. If the journal you have chosen to submit your article does not provide any instruction on how long your abstract should be, what is the general guideline you should use in the case? 100 to 150, 150 to 200, 200 to 250, as many words as you like. Think a while. That's right. The correct answer is option 3. If there is no guidance provided by the journal you intend to submit your article, then a typical length of your abstract should be between 200 to 250 words. An abstract is a summary of your article and should be concise. Template to write the paper. Now we are moving on to how to write the paper. Use an ADDIE model. Analyze, design, develop, implement, evaluate. This would be useful for engineering, technology, and science investigations. Not for literature, not for other arena. So maximum ADDIE model is helpful for engineering and technology, science research, experimentation. Most important part of the research paper, title, abstract, keywords. These three are going to become the marketing agent of your paper. Why it is important? The title, abstract, and the keywords play a pivotal role in the communication of your research to the world. Most electronic research engines like Google, Yahoo Search, Rediff Search, etc., databases or journal websites will use the words found in your title and abstract and your listed keywords to decide whether and when to display your paper to interested readers. So it should create excitement, it should be apt, it should be precise and concise, acceptable, readable, aesthetic, all you may have to apply. Title. Create a sentence that includes the keywords which you listed. Avoid unnecessary or repeated words. Make sure your research title describes the topic or the method, the sample, the results of your study. You can use the following formula if you wish. Result, start with a method, study of topic, and a sample. For example, let us take this. Systematizing big data analytics, applications, and analytical solutions to the cloud. Content is clear, has sufficient coverage, flow can be better, some paraphrasing needed, grammatical mistakes. Changed. Applications and analytical solutions to the cloud using big data. This is my recommendation. You can even rewrite better than this. Performance evaluation of interleaved soft switching KY converters for your PV system using contemporary controllers. Trendy topic. New KY converter is a trendy topic. Missing KY converters. Why this and not others? Using hardware in real time, grammatical minor mistakes. Numerical investigations of solar-based Stirling engine using MATLAB. Methodology is good, where and when the experiments are going to be done. Specify the parameters to be studied, geometry, materials, and gas or fluid, etc. Good research paper titles. Typically 10 to 12 words long. Use descriptive terms and phrases that accurately highlight the core content of the paper. Next, abstract. An abstract is a concise summary of complicated work or work in progress. In short, a reader can learn the rationale behind the study, general approach to the problem, obtained results, and important conclusion. Maybe 200 to 500 words if it is recommended. Otherwise, As we discussed previous slides, it should be confined to 200 to 250 words. Abstract always should provide the answer for 5W1H model. What is the meaning of 5W1H model? Why this research is useful or important? Who are all involved? What is carried out? When it is conducted? Where it is conducted? Which is algorithm used? How it is conducted? How it is better than other research? How it is better than that algorithm? How the results are better than the previous one? How this research is going to be useful for the future endeavor? Such kind of answers are to be provided for these questions. What is my paper about? What techniques or designs were used? What were the obtained results? Why your methodology is efficient one? When did you conduct the experiment? Where did you conduct the experiment? Which is the mathematical model or research strategy carried out? Who, whom, how did you carry out the entire research, model, methodology, procedure, etc.? This has to be, answers for these questions has to be covered. First, you can simply write answer for each and every question. Today, you may be very particular about what is my paper about. Write it. Keep it aside. Tomorrow, you may be coming out with techniques, designs. Then write answer. Simple 2 to 3 lines answer. Keep it aside. Once if you have got answers for all the questions, remove all the questions. Then rearrange. Rearrange the paraphrases and use more connecting words. And synthesize, and then it become very good abstract. In simple terms, abstract is a summarization of the problem, methods, results, and conclusions in a single paragraph. Make it interesting and understandable. Make it accurate and specific. A clear abstract will strongly influence whether or not your work is considered. Keep it as brief as possible. How to write? Write abstracts in active voice. For example, researchers showed previously that smoking can lead to lung cancer. Instead, it was previously demonstrated that lung cancer can be caused by smoking. Avoid being general and vague. Be specific. Let us see a few examples for active voice and passive voice. Active voice always should start with the subject. Next, it should move on to the action and object. But in the passive voice, it starts with object, action, and subject. Sally drove her car off the road. The car was driven off the road by Sally. The dog bit Timmy on the arm. Timmy was bitten on the arm by the dog. This one example. Let us see few more. Active and passive voice. Active form. The professor teaches the students. The students are taught by the professor. Avoid by. By is whenever by is used passive voice. Always research article or throw the research paper. It is advisable to use active voice. What is the merit is when we try writing any sentences in the active voice, it will form with a lesser number of words, then words limitation will not become a problem. Within concise way of writing, we can effectively communicate the experimentation and our research work. So that's why always it is recommended to practice or write the research paper using active voice. The cat drank the milk. The milk was drunk by the cat. Passive voice. This occurs when the object comes before the subject in a sentence. This pattern shows the receiver before the doer of the action. The floor was swept by the girl. Passive voice. To be avoided. Passive voice again. The mouse was eaten by the cat. The mouse ate the cat. See, look at every slide. If you start counting the number of words used in the active voice, always it's much more lesser than the number of words used in the passive voice. It's added advantage. It's easy for reading. It's easy for understanding. It creates more interest as well as it reduces the length of the paper. That will create more excitement for the readers. Which of the following options are written in the active voice? Please select three options. Look at this for a while and read it carefully. One thumb rule is wherever you are seeing by, it's not at all an active voice. This is not at all an active voice. This is not at all an active voice. This is not at all an active voice. First eliminate, filter it out. The moment you see by, all ought to be eliminated. Then keep rehearsing the rest of the three items. Among those three, which are all active voice. Try it. Then types of abstract. Generally between 100 and 300 words in length, abstracts are different types, descriptive, informative, and structured. Always descriptive abstracts, when people can prefer is qualitative research, explaining using only the English with the diagrams, simple tables, figures, these all qualitative research. Quasi-experimentation, little experimentation using Excel, very simple calculation, categorization, tabulation. Informative abstracts are commonly used in the sciences and the present information on the background, aim, methods, results, and conclusion. Structured abstract suits for engineering and technology. Objective, design, methods, experimental design, results, and conclusions. When these all incorporated, then the name of the abstract is said to be structured abstract. Next, keywords. Keywords represent the content of your manuscript. Be specific to your field or subfield. Keywords are important words or concepts found in your research question or thesis. Keywords only will decide suitability to the journal and where to publish your paper, the section of the journal, type of the journal, indexing of the journal will happen only with keywords in all the databases and the search engines. Good to have 4 to 5 keywords at the maximum. If they recommend the maximum, they may recommend 6. You have written an article on effectively using solar cells to power motor vehicle. Which of the following is suitable keyword for this article? Think a while. Traditional energy sources, alternative energy sources, solar energy, fuels, SPC, which is an abbreviation you have coined for solar power cell. Introduction. The purpose of an introduction is to gain the reader's attraction and the rationale behind the work. With the intention of defending your research, it places your work in a theoretical context and enables the reader to understand and appreciate your objectives. Normally, it is recommended to use 500 to 800 words. Research paper introduction paragraph, how we can write? If you provide answer for some or for all of this question, then it becomes wonderful introduction section. What is already available? Background knowledge or simple terms literature review. One paragraph or two paragraph relevant literature review or the base paper which you refer for conducting that particular research could be done. What problem is identified? What solution we propose? What are the specific details about the solution? What are its advantages? How is the rest of the research paper organized? Provide a brief context to the readers. Address the problem, identify what the work is trying to achieve, provide a perspective consistent with the nature of the journal. Now, food for thought. You are sending a paper to a publisher. The paper is on the effects of coffee on sleep patterns of women in the age group 25 to 35 years. You had earlier written a paper on the effects of coffee on sleep of men across the same age groups. You reuse the introduction section from your previous article. Is it acceptable? It's your own paper. What would be your answer? Definitely no. It will become a plagiarism where your own paper or somebody else's paper, and when we are conducting different research, submitting to different journal, it should be avoided. That's correct. although it can be tempting to you to use. Since it's your paper, you will feel temptation. Introductions from your previous papers on similar studies. Every paper should present a new result and the work should be specifically motivated. This requires a unique introduction every time. Next, analysis section. The purpose of the analysis phase is to analyze and summarize the existing literature, experimental work done, and the existing materials, methods, general procedure, etc. So that reader may use for their study or judge the merit of your work. In simple terms, it's a step-by-step description of how do you arrive at your problem. Recommended words are 800 to 1000 words. Again, if you have answer for some or all of the questions, analysis section is ready for you. What are the existing works in this field and why isn't it already solved? What did we understand from the existing work? What is our analysis of the existing work? What is our identified research work? Its depth and why we have chosen this paper? What are all the tools, technologies, equipments, models, data set, tasks, mathematical models are required for your research and why did we select them? Every day, keep writing answer for one or two questions. Within a week or within a month, you could be able to cover the analysis section easily. Then remove all the questions, rewrite, rearrange, rephrase all the answers. It will become beautiful analysis section. Coming to design, again, it may be repeating some of the analysis section. The purpose of the design phase is to propose the plan of conduction of the research study. What is the overall layout or outline and the plan of our study? What is a step-by-step research procedure? What is initial prototype test? What are the opening points and the closing remarks, boundary conditions of research? What is the created evaluation strategy for the results of the study? Methods. Describe how the problem was studied. Include detailed information. Do not describe previously published procedures. Identify the equipment and materials used. Next, development section or phase. It's a step-by-step description of how do we develop a system or model or a solution for the problem. Recommended words are 800 to 1000. Again, there is a template. If you answer for some or all of the questions, development phase is ready. What is the overall layout or outline and plan of study? What is a step-by-step research conducting procedure? What is the initial prototype test? What are the opening points and the closing points, boundary conditions for research? What is the created evaluation strategy for the study? Implementation phase. Again, I'm providing a template. Answer for each and every question. Remove the question, rephrase, and connect each and every answer. Then it becomes wonderful implementation section. The purpose of the implementation phase is to tell the steps of how the research sequence are conducted. What did we evaluate in this study? How do our findings compare or contrast improve with other studies? Are there any new findings, innovations? What is the significance of the study? Are there any limitations, discrepancies, interpretations, etc.? Testing and evaluation. The purpose of the evaluation phase is to observe results and interpret findings. 800 to 1000 words. What did we evaluate in the study? How do our findings compare, contrast, improve with other studies? Are there any new findings, innovation? Again, the same. The way of writing may be different. Results. Include only data of primary importance. Use subheadings to keep results of the same type together. Be clear and easy to understand. Highlight the main findings of the research. Provide statistical findings. Include illustrations and findings. When you are writing the results section of your article, which of the following guidelines should you follow? Think a while. Food for thought. Included of primary and secondary importance. Use subheadings to keep results of the same type together. Do not highlight findings that differ from previous findings. Include illustrations and figures. Use scale markers for every photograph and image. When writing result section, you should include data of primary importance only. You should also use subheadings to keep results of the same type together so that they are easy to review and read. Additionally, you should highlight findings that differ from previous findings as well as highlight findings that future understanding in the field. You should use illustrations including figures, tables, image with a scale marker are the most efficient way to present the results. Discussion section. If you answer some or all of the questions, it becomes easy. Interpretation of results, most important section. Make the discussion correspond to the results and then complement them. Compare published results with your own. Be careful not using the following statements that go beyond what the results can support. Artificially, superficially, by imagining something we should not write. Non-specific expressions. New terms not already defined or mentioned in your paper. Speculations on possible interpretations based on imagination. Conclusion. The purpose of conclusion is to summarize and suggest future directions, results, findings, and interpretation. Recommended words are 200 to 500 words. What did we expect and what did we get? Why did we get this? What is the significance of this study and why did it occur? What else could be improved in the future experimentations? Who will it benefit? Answer for these questions. Always conclusion should be clear, provide justification for the work, explain how your work advances the present stage of the knowledge, suggest future experiments. Why is referencing important? The last section, reference section. Citations are not used simply to avoid plagiarism. They have other important roles too. References allows you to acknowledge the contribution of other writers and researchers in your work. Referencing is a way to provide evidence to support the assertions and the claims in your work. Assignments. Why is referencing important again? References should always be accurate, allowing your readers to trace the sources of information you have used. Citations also make your writing more persuasive. Always based on the citations only, H index, impact factor, and these all laurels, achievements, invited talks, speakers, everything will come through citations. It's a genuine tendency to use references, whichever we come across, to accomplish the success of the research or experimentation or in writing the paper. Reference, when you are using words or ideas from books and journal articles, newspapers and magazines, websites or electronic resources. Reference when you reprint any diagrams, illustration, charts or pictures. For these all occasions, we may have to cite it, we may have to mention genuinely. No need to reference. When you are writing your own observations or experiment results, for example, a report on a field trip, when you are writing about your own experiences, for example, a reflective journal, when you are writing your own thoughts, comments, and conclusion in an assignment, no need to mention. When you are evaluating or offering your own analysis, when you are using common knowledge, common facts that can be found in numerous places, and are likely to be known by a lot of people or folklore in that particular domain. When you are using generally accepted facts or information, this varies in different disciplines of the study. If in doubt, ask your tutor, mentor, or advisor, experienced people. Acknowledgement. If you reuse pamphlets or brochures, films, documentaries, television programs, advertisements, letters, emails, online discussion forums, personal interviews, lecturers or tutors, mentor or advisor, or funding agencies, not always necessary, but check with your lecturer or tutor about their preferences before you draw on their ideas. Referencing systems, APA referencing, they will mention the order of mention writing the reference, whether you have to start with the author, whether you have to use semicolon to separate two author names, the representation of writing the reference. Always reference will carry on name of the authors or contributors, title of the research paper, name of the journal, and volume, issues, and ISSN number. These all will be there normally. What are all the elements you can use it, in which order, what representation, within double quotation, or with italic form, or with bold effect, these all mentioned or predefined in these referencing formats. APA format, MLA format, Chicago format, Turabian format, IEEE format, which journal you are submitting, they themselves will give guidelines to the authors. We may have to read carefully and we may have to become familiar with how to write references using these formats. Then we may have to adapt the way of writing references. Citation machine. You can use it, a website that formats your citations in different styles for you. There are plenty of online mechanisms available. If you provide all the necessary information or title of the paper, then automatically it will customize what reference style you require. Then it will display to you. You can copy and paste it. Nowadays, things are becoming very simple with the support of online tools and softwares. We must thank the digital revolution. You are writing the references section of your article. Which of the following guidelines should you follow? Cite as many references possible. Avoid citations of your own work. Focus your references on one region. Ensure that you are fully understanding, you are fully understanding the material you are referencing. Feedback. When writing a reference list, you should not include too many references, especially if they are only tangentially related to your work, very relevant, close to your research. You should include self-citations of your work as long as they are exempt. You should also avoid multiple citations from a single region or institute. That shows the bias. One particular institute, one particular region. We may have to always prefer to cite Scopus Index Journal, ISI Index Journal, or Science Direct Journals. Only then it will become more beneficial for conducting the research also. It gives a better outlook for your paper. It becomes a best marketing method. Additionally, you should always ensure that you have fully absorbed and understood the material you are referencing. Do not just rely on reading excerpts or isolated sentences. Know what you are referencing. Imitative learning, just drag and drop high quality documents and look up for subject specific vocabulary and language ideas while you are writing. Use refandwrite.com website. In your domain, what are all the paper or what are all the arena of the research you are conducting? If you give some specificity, automatically it will give suggestive list of words, ideas. You can collect it and comprehend and rephrase it and write it. It may help you towards imitative learning. You no need to think originally. Something will be there. You may have to rephrase it, rewrite it. So this is a wonderful website. You can use it for your research writing. Visual words. It gives you again vocabulary, the different way of using. Like how we have friends networking. Similarly, words also has friends there. So its own friends list, family of words. Then it helps us to phrase the sentences. English grammar test you can use. Vocabulary builder app you can use. How to get published and preparing your manuscript. Avoid duplicate of published work, outdated work, and incorrect conclusions. Increase up-to-date review. Significant enhancement of published work and original results and methods we may have to use. Are you ready to publish? You have carried out an extensive experiment and plan to slice the findings for submission of several different papers to multiple journals. Is this acceptable practice? Yes or no? Think about it. This is known as salami slicing. and involves breaking up or segmenting a large study into two or more publications. These segments are referred to as the slices of a study. As a general rule, as long as the slices of a broken up study share the same hypothesis, population, and methods, this is not acceptable practice. The same slice should never be published more than once. General structure of a research article now. When publishing at the end, it should be in the structure. To start with, you have to start with the figures and tables. Then you have to move on to the methods, you have to move on to the strategies. But while submitting a paper, it should be rearranged and it should be maintained in this order. Title, abstract, keywords, introduction, methods, results and discussion, conclusion. Acknowledgements, reference, supporting materials, effective manuscript titles, attract readers' attention, contain fewest possible words. General structure of a research article again, adequately describe content, are informative and concise, identify the main issue, do not use technical jargon and ready use the abbreviations. The correct options are 1, 2, 3. These are written in the active voice question. While options 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, and 6 are written in the passive voice. Excluding all the by, then remaining will become active voice. Academic publishing cycle. Publish and disseminate, solicit, manage submissions, manage peer review, edit and prepare production. Always, this is the order for publishing a paper. Computer-aided plant identification through leaf recognition using enhanced image processing and machine learning algorithms. Look at this. You have to rewrite plant identification through leaf recognition using what genetic algorithm? Interdepartmental, botany and computer science, alignment to justified, reduce number of words. The name of the algorithm is missing in the abstract. So you may have to write like this. This is another recommendation or giving exposure. Research discussion. You can make use of the benefit of online websites, Quora, ResearchGate, Google Scholar for CSAD, Geeks for Geeks team always will give answers to anybody's question, whomever post S-Logics. Visualization and the plots. Easily, you can pull the data, feed the data, coding will be ready. Here and there you may have to customize. Then for the data you may get wonderful, beautiful, dynamic visual outputs. Dynamic also, static also. You may have to customize what kind of plot suits for your data set. You may have to little bit apply your thought process. Get associated with Sri Vishnu Educational Society for more problems and for more insights, ATL, State University of New York, Binghamton, National Remote Sensing Center, Qualcomm, Solar Energy, High-Tech Printers, Anjali Cement Powder, Fresh Choice, Food Processing Center, Tiles Manufacturing Unit, Video Processing, Indexing and Retrieval. Get attached with the special labs or Center of Excellence to expand your knowledge, to expand your capability, to arouse your curiosity level. Our insights of thinking are creating research mindset. These are all the avenues. Or we may have to rely on networking with the people. Or we may have to rely on online websites. So these are all the means to get associated to explore more with the scientific experimentation. Always using this research in our research. Don't use I, V. Avoid I and V. Use the word, suppose if it is educational research, use in our affiliated university. Don't mention that JNTU Hyderabad, Anna University, JNTU Kakinada. This never we should mention. Use in our affiliated university. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe the channel for notifications. Wish you all success.